Last weekend, The Amazing Spider-Man 2 opened in AMC theaters everywhere, with the Web Slinger taking in just over $92 million at the box office on its opening weekend. That number is up from the last Spider-Man movie, which made $75 million on its opening weekend. John, buy or sell that this is a good opening weekend result for The Amazing Spider-Man 2.
I'm going to actually sell that this is a good result for The Amazing Spider-Man 2. Now, yeah, keep in mind, this is a marked improvement over the opening weekend of the last Amazing Spider-Man, absolutely. But that film was great, so most people liked it, so you had to anticipate that the next film was going to open up big. It beat out the opening weekend for Captain America. But once again, here's why, though, I think you have to be a little bit disappointed in the result, the box office result, because the initial marketing on this Spider-Man film looked insanely good. Insanely good. But I think what kept it from crossing that $100 million, even $110 million opening weekend box office mark was two things. One, we talked about this, fatigue. They released so much marketing for this film, I think people forgot it was even coming out. I mean, it's just they forgot it wasn't already in theaters. I mean, we've just seen so much of it that is just way too heavy. Plus, Schnepp, you didn't like the film. Dennis and I generally liked it. We gave it a positive score. But it's suffice it to say that people didn't love this movie. And so I think there was a very key mistake here made. I think it backfired on them by releasing the movie in a lot of different markets before it opened here. I think Sony genuinely believes this was an awesome movie, and they had a lot of confidence in it. And they thought releasing it overseas first was going to get the positive word of mouth going. Everybody in North America would hear about how everybody's loving it. Then it would open here, and boom. However, it backfired. There have been lukewarm reviews coming back, mixed, lukewarm, and that's being generous, coming back. So I think some people's enthusiasm was kind of waned by what they heard about it. They also combined that with the fact of the over-marketing fatigue. I think that hurt it. Still, if I'm a filmmaker and I release a movie that made $95, $92 million opening weekend, even if it's The Amazing Spider-Man 2, I'm popping some champagne. I just think it could have been a little bit, I think the results could have been better. Dennis?
I'm going to sell it as well because it's a decent opening. Not a great opening. I think they wanted to go over 100, maybe 110.
Let's be clear, though. For most movies, it's a ridiculously fantastic opening.
It is.
For The Amazing Spider-Man 2, though, it's an okay opening.
Especially given the factors that, one, the marketing push for this movie is much bigger than the first one. When they did the reboot for The Amazing Spider-Man, they were unsure. They're like, okay, we're kind of rebooting the origin, so let's see how this goes, and it made 75. This one, they went full force with it. They're like, okay, we got this villain, this villain, this villain. We got all these visual effects. Everyone's going to love it. And so they pushed it really big, and it ended up not doing as well as they wanted to. And and I think part of it has to do with unfavorable reviews or mixed feelings.
Right. Schnepp.
A lot of people might have read my Instagram review. I did not like The Amazing Spider-Man 2. It worked for some people. It didn't work for me. I thought the tone was all over the place. It felt like a kid's movie. I mean, I think if you're a 10-year-old kid or you're a family who wants to bring their kids to see The Amazing Spider-Man, that works. Otherwise, it's not. It's a film that just didn't work for me, and that's my opinion, so.
Hey everyone, if you like this video, click that thumbs up button and make sure to subscribe to our AMC Movie News YouTube channel. It's free and helps you stay up to date with all the latest movie news, as well as our daily AMC Movie Talk Show. Also, make sure that you follow us on Facebook and Twitter to stay up to date with all of our special promotions, contests, and prize giveaways.